The cabinet is taking a media relations seminar after starting off on the wrong foot with reporters. This comes amid reports of infighting in President Aquino's camp over positions in his communications office, the agency that will relay his programs to the people. Tonight, we look at the relationship between the palace and the press and how this affects the public they both serve. I'm Tony Velasquez, sitting in for Cheche Lazaro. Join me as we put the media in focus.
They expected a honeymoon, but officials of the Aquino administration got a backlash from the media on their very first day in office. First, there was presidential spokesperson Edwin Lacerda. Lacerda got a baptism of fire, drawing flak for the palace's decision to revise its first ever official order. Last Wednesday, Lacerda presented a memorandum circular to reporters declaring all non-career executive service positions vacant. Just a day later, Lacerda backtracked, saying Malacanang extended the term of non-career officials until July 31st to ensure continuous government service. The lawyer had a heated exchange with reporters on what to call the sudden change.
You mentioned earlier that ES Ochoa signed it. Are you saying he'll be responsible for this blooper?
He signed this. He's responsible for the document that he signed. The description of the document as a blooper is entirely your own. I do not agree.
But even before that, Lacerda already earned the ire of the Malacanang Press Corps for showing up late at the same press conference. While waiting for him, reporters were surprised to find out he already broke the news to ANC through a phone interview.
I just came down to apologize.
Lacerda apologized, saying he committed to speak to ANC. This time, he agreed to call the mistake a mortal sin. It wasn't just Lacerda who got off to a rocky start with the media. That same day, Brother Armin Luisto started his stint as Education Secretary. Asked about his comments on sex education, the De La Salle brother gave this response.
Alam nyo, yung media hindi nakakatulong. Pag-aaway-awayin at saka hindi napapag-usapan ng maayos, mahinahon, we will talk about it without media. So wag na ninyo akong tatanungin tungkol sa sex education kasi hindi kayo nakakatulong.
The fallout from the comments of Luisto and Lacerda prompted President Aquino to apologize for his cabinet.
Kasi hindi naman siguro normal sa sino man tao na ano, para bang haharap sa lahat at knowledgeable on everything all the time. At kung paano yung delivery. So yung all of those basics na will be tackled in a seminar by the same people who helped me in my senatorial campaign and also in the presidential campaign.
It turns out, it's not just the memorandum that his officials need to fine-tune, but the relationship with the media as well.
And joining us are former Press Secretary Mike Toledo, who served during the Estrada administration, journalist and blogger Ellen Tordesillas, and political strategist Malou, the founder and general manager of the firm Publicus Asia. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Hi, good evening.
Good evening,
for coming to the show. Well, I guess everybody's seen the first few days of the Aquino administration has somehow not been very organized in terms of their communications strategy or communications approach. Ellen, you actually saw a problem with the way siguro they handled the information now because of what? The lack of an organized communication structure?
Not only the structure, but who is in charge ba? Yun yung number one, kasi there is, well, we used to have the, when we were covering Malacanang, the press secretary, you know. I don't know if they're going to revamp the office of the press secretary, but if they have to revamp, to reorganize it, then what's the new setup? The most important thing is there must be someone on top. And as of now, wala yun.
Yeah. Well, tell me, why fix something if it ain't broke? I mean, does it look like it needs fixing, Malou, or revamping?
As far as I'm concerned, when you are transitioning to the office of the president, there are key people already who are identified to take charge on certain things before the inaugural. Apparently, even during the inaugural, the link with the institution is not that clear yet. Secondly, the other thing that I would want to bring out is that it appears that there's a different take on how communications is supposed to help the institution of the presidency. There is communication. Former Secretary Mike Toledo would probably elaborate on that. There is communication, mm-hmm. and there is media relations, and there is media operations.
Okay.
When you talk about communications, that's the long, overarching messaging theme of the administration. It controls the agenda that which you communicate. Who will implement the communication would now be your media relations and your media operations. I think that in itself has not been clearly defined. So even, I think the critical part in the Filipino tradition, kailangan may timon.
Okay.
Sino yung timon could probably have these things moving.
Sabi nga ni Ellen, so who's heading it?
Diba? Kasi if they're just waiting, talagang walang mangyayari.
So, but the structure has always been there because, you know, as Ellen and I know, of course, former Press Sec Mike Toledo here knows, nandun naman yun. I mean, it's institutionalized.
Yes.
All you need to do is to put in key people and then it's functioning. So, why not put people in right away? Ibig sabihin nun, what's holding them back? What do you think, Ellen?
I wrote something about it.
Yeah, yeah.
There's really there's the problem of factions within the Noynoy organization.
Mm.
So, but Noynoy has to decide is the president. Mm-hmm. So what if there's there are people with conflicting interests? He has to decide.
Mm. And conflicting interests meaning what? What do they want to control?
Yeah, of course. The communications department. I mean, it's a very powerful department.
Mm. No, because are there two ways of sending out Noynoy Aquino's message? I mean, in terms of policy,
it would appear like that. Considering that there's a conflict between purists who are communicators and really media handlers.
Mm.
So if there is no one marching order, or appointing one person who will oversee the implementation of this. You know, we're in week one.
Yeah.
And there have been like 3 policy speeches made where you don't see really government. It's like we're still in inaugural.
Walang coherence.
Wala.
Uh-uh.
Diba? You had the inaugural.
Yeah.
It's time for you to, you know, churn it out and do a nationwide probably definition of what this administration is. You had the AFP policy speech,
right,
which is very, very critical when he said civilian supremacy lies, military, what is that?
There's civilian supremacy over the military.
Oh, yes. And then the Air Force.
Mm.
So those are really very, very key pronouncements that apparently is not sinking to the ordinary one.
But that's President Noy himself, because he actually delivers the speech and he's responsible for the message right away. But for other policy decisions of the government, and Press Secretary Mike, you know, it's important that you manage to effectively explain why policies are decided that way and what they're supposed to accomplish. So let's say, for example, you announce Memorandum Circular 1 and then people are confused. Hey, wait a minute, anong masasagasaan nun?